Hey guys, Rob here with another RubberToe Assembly of the 10x8 Outdoor Storage Shed by Lifetime. Alright, right off the bat, on to section 6, the domed skylight. It's one of the roof panels that has a hole, just like you see here, a big square in it. There should be two of these. This is your first one. I just went through real quick here, like you saw with the screwdriver, that little screwdriver I have, and just pop those holes open, because that's going to make the screw go easier later on. And your first strip of weather stripping tape, it's real sticky here, so just got to be careful. You roll the stuff out. Do your bottom line first, just like you see there. That line right there is going to be the bottom of the window when it's up there, installed on the roof. And then both of your sides, this one overlaps as you see here. I lay the tape down, give a nice straight cut there. If you have a nice sharp blade on your box cutter knife, that's best, works best. And then you just push it down with your thumb into that groove there, nice and tight as you can, right down in there, so it's hold, you know, it's airtight, watertight, nice. And as you can see, great shot there of the strip. Just roll it out just like you see me doing it right here. And then you give it a nice straight cut on the other side, boom. And then push down hard with your thumb down into that groove. Make sure it's a nice, tight, airtight, watertight seal there. It sticks real good. And then you peel that top part off. So the sides and your bottom are all lined up. And then you just come across the top here with the remaining, what you have left. Should be just enough. They give you just enough to do this. And then you stretch it across and then give it a nice straight cut. And then go back over it with your thumb and push down real hard into that groove. And so all the pieces are overlapping each other, just like the roof tiles. That should really help with no leaks, being airtight. Nice. And then you peel the strip when it's done. Perfect. Done perfectly. These are already started. These could take, you know, like 10 minutes each side sometimes, peeling these sides off. But I got them all ready to go. So I'll just show you. Both sides have to come off, because the sun's going to be hitting this. You don't want it to hit these things and have cracks and then have leaks or anything. Boom. Inside and outside of these windows. So it's a nice piece of window there. Nice, clean, nice, ready to go. And you line it up just like you see here perfectly. It has to be lined up perfectly on there. If it overlaps a little on one edge and then it overlapping a little on the other edge too, and you think, eh, it's not quite perfect, maybe about a quarter of an inch or less, an eighth of an inch overlap. As long as the edges are all evenly overlapping, just like you see there, and it's perfectly centered in, you know, with it, then your holes should line up that you cleared already earlier with these screws. And I put them on a little stubby Phillips head screwdriver, and that helps me push these things through. You just push real hard and push them right through. They go right through the plastic, through the weather stripping sticky stuff, and then right through the hole in the roof and out the other side. And you're going to come back later after you put these screws in, put washers and nuts on the inside, on the other side of these screws. And you're going to clean them first, because they're going to have goop on them. So it's a little plastic weather stripping stuff on the threads. So you clean that goop off. I'm going to show you a trick here in a minute coming up. But as you see, I'm going through the last couple of screws here with that little stubby Phillips head screwdriver. It's the best way to do this. It goes poof right in, usually the first time. And that window being lined up perfectly with these holes, that's crucial. And it's sticky. So you, when you put the window on there, make sure you do it right the first time. You don't want to be sliding it around, moving it. Oh, it's not quite straight, because it just gets sticky stuff all over the place. So I go to the screws. As you saw, I flip it over, go to the threads on the screws, and I use the excess tar, the sticky stuff that I peel off the first one, and use it to stick onto the next piece, and so on, like a rolling ball down a mountain of snow. It just gets bigger and bigger. Yeah, snowball effect. There you go. And that's how I take off all the sticky stuff on each one. As you go around, it just gets easier and easier, because the snowball of little sticky stuff just gets added to and added to, and it helps you. You stick that to the threads, and it just literally helps to pull the stuff right off. As you see, they're all nice and clean now. Going through, snapping the washers on, and then spinning those little 3/8 nuts on there, those little cap nuts. Put a washer first on each one all the way around, and then put a little cap nut on top of that. And then I come through after that, as you see, I went through there, and with that little same stubby Phillips on one side and a 3/8 socket, it looks like, on my drill gun on the other, I set my torque to medium to low there on these and just snug them up nice and snug. You don't want to go overboard on these either, because you don't want to pull them in too tight. Just snug them up nice so the washers don't. And it's, and then you come through after they're all tightened up, just like you see here. I'm pushing my thumb down and getting rid of any kind of air pockets that you see there. Boom, great shot here. Little shadows there, but you can clearly see that I'm just running my thumb across the top nice and firmly and pushing out any possible little bubbles of any sort. So you have a nice straight bead. Alright, on to section 7, the floor assembly. These four pieces, it looks like maybe 8x10 then, just four pieces here. They lock in just like you see there. Someone standing on that first piece always helps, or if you have an edge of a wall that you can push up against to hold that piece where it goes. Once you get your first two pieces connected, it adds a little bit more weight to it as you go. The third piece, still if someone's standing there, it makes it a lot easier standing on the pieces that are already stationary. That third piece dropped right in, nice and perfect there. Wow, that was great. And then that fourth piece drops in the same way as your ends, and you have your two middles. So all four pieces are linked together. Nice, you come back. The instructions show you here, you come back and screw that down after, but these are your door bushings. One here on the left, because your center doors are gonna be here. So you're gonna make sure that when you lay your flooring down, as you see here, put these bushings in there. You probably have to take them out later to get the walls in, but this will ensure that your doors will be in the right place. See how there's a hole there and a hole, the first hole where I put? Those are gonna, that's what you want, because your doors are gonna swing there. This is crucial. You don't wanna have to come back through and take everything apart just to change your flooring around. So those two bushings are inserted just as you see here. Make sure that your doors will be in the right spot, and then you just put two screws in where they go here, two on the side there by the bushing, two right here in the middle, and then two on the opposite side towards the back. That will be your back of the shed, the back wall area. And the ones where the bushings are going to be the front of the, where your doors are, it's going to be the front of the shed. So as you see here, there's six total on that line. There'll be six total little screws on this line. When you screw these down, I think the instruction shows you a little circle with a line through it saying don't do this, don't, and to do it the right way, another one without the line through it, where the screw is a little bit too far pushing into the flooring, and then there's another shot with the screw is nice and flush with the flooring. So yeah, don't go too crazy on these screws and sink them into the flooring too far down. Nice snug, maybe a little bit sunk, but not that much, so it's nice and flush. Alright guys, great. Another section of this great rubber toe assembly of the 10x8 shed. Thanks for watching. Here it is, completed. I've got other videos that are hopefully very helpful to you guys. Alright, again, rubber toe assembly. Thanks, please subscribe.